More than half of the people our contact tracers are getting in touch with are refusing to cooperate. This is highly disturbing, to say the very least.
In August, a frustrated New Jersey Governor Phil Murphy urged people to provide information to contact tracers.
Please, folks, take the damn call. Work with them.
But the governor's plea hasn't worked. In fact, it's now 63% of people reached by contact tracers after testing positive who refuse to say where they've been or who they've been with.
They don't want to put their friends and loved ones in a position to have to quarantine and perhaps be out of their work for 2 weeks.
The public has also been slow to embrace the new COVID Alert New Jersey and New York apps introduced last month, which are supposed to be powerful tools for contact tracing.
About 5% of the population that we expected downloaded. We would like it to be 15%.
Phones with the app emit a changing sequence of numbers that can only be detected by another phone with the app when the two come within 6 feet of each other for 15 minutes. If the owner of that phone later tests positive for COVID-19, all phones linked to it in the past 14 days are alerted they may have been exposed to the virus. State officials say it's not a GPS tracker, as some fear.
We don't know where it's occurred. All we know is that you have been exposed to someone who has tested positive, and we're here to help you.
Another reason that contact tracing hasn't been as effective as it could be is that most new cases involve people 18 to 45. They're less likely to become seriously ill, and it seems less likely to call the health department. But that's short-sighted, says the commissioner.
What if your mother or your father or your grandparents get exposed from you? And they end up in the hospital, and they end up in ICU, and God forbid, they end up dying. That has happened.
There are also scammers pretending to be contact tracers, trying to frighten people into revealing personal and financial information needed for identity theft. It's not a widespread scam, but it's another reason people may be reluctant to cooperate with legitimate contact tracers.
What level of cooperation with the contact tracers do you think you need to see?
I would love to see 100%.
Yeah.
But right now, I'd like 75%. I think we could do a really good job at mitigating the disease, stopping the spread.
Well, you're a long way from there.
We're a long way. We have a lot of work to do.
I'm Arnold Diaz, PIX 11 News.